Detective Chief Inspector CID. I've come to investigate the mysterious death of Dr. Black. So, the victim was killed by Saturday Night Fever.
Cluedo was incredibly popular when I was a child. I mean, I'm talking 40 years ago, when murder was an incredibly evil, almost exotic thing to comprehend.
The murder of the unfortunate Dr. Black.
Dr. Black!
It was invented by Anthony Pratt. He always had the idea of a murder game, and then decided that he didn't quite like the idea of it. He thought the idea of a murder game was wrong somehow, and changed it fundamentally into a detection game. And that is the main thrust of Cluedo, not the murder, but the detection.
It is Miss Scarlet with a piece of lead piping in the conservatory.
There are six people in the frame for this terrible murder. Suspect number one, the ultimate Scarlet Woman. Demure, sophisticated, Miss Vivian Scarlet. It was she who found the body, so the Cluedo conundrum starts with her.
It's all very much about people in beautiful clothes and cliched people, the beautiful woman, the gold digger who did it.
Got the Agatha Christie, you know, Touch of Frost, everything. It's all down to sort of murder, mystery, kind of, it's part of British heritage. The characters have almost become household names in themselves.
A military man is trained to kill. Therefore, he might have access to what could be the murder weapon.
Colonel Mustard started his life as Mr. Yellow.
Then he was changed to Colonel Mustard, and people talk of Colonel Mustard as if he's a special character, as if he might have been a Conan Doyle character, for instance. Actually, it's a Waddington's character.
Cluedo and the world Cluedo champion, dressed as ever as Colonel Mustard, is with us in the studio.
I think the Edwardian Agatha Christie style whodunits are for kind of pseudo-intellectuals, basically. You wouldn't get one of those whodunit lovers wanting to work out a whodunit based on drug smuggling in Jamaica.
I first started with the 1976 Monopoly Championships, which is when they began. I'm the only person who still takes part from the original championships. Then along came the Cluedo Championships, and in 1993 became the UK champion and became the world champion. They say, stay away.
Don't want you home today. You know, the fact that you are world champion, I don't want to devalue your achievement, but might have something to do with the fact that not many people play.
He fits the bill perfectly. Great character.
It does help, definitely.
I'll never forget when he turned up at the airport in his Colonel Mustard outfit.
Well, I'd look silly in a red dress.
He actually believed he was Colonel Mustard. In America, for them to see sort of a colonel, you know, walking around the streets of New York, he definitely helped us to publicise the game. You're an embarrassment.
Never eliminate a suspect when they have a secret they want to keep hidden.
The success of the board game led to a hit TV series.
But what dark secret did she bring to Arlington Grange?
Back in the 80s, Cluedo was just a massive TV program. It was incredibly popular.
What on earth?
It gave you an opportunity to not only have fun, but to work with people you'd never otherwise work with.
Oh, wonderful. It's a mystery. Oh, it's a mystery. I'm still searching for a clue.
I was just playing someone who hated the Kate O'Mara character. I mean, very cliche role, and you know, the way we were directed, everything, you know, we pinpointed everything because clues had to kind of come with a big black outline around them. So it wasn't about subtlety at all.
You lying, betraying. I'll see you in hell.
Have you seen Mrs. Peacock?
Drawing room.
I think there was an enormous amount of tongue-in-cheek, and it, you know, it pandered to the board game, and it's, this is fun. And this is not Crime Watch, this is fun.
This is the hardest case in my career. And Tudor Close was awash with red herrings. Amateur sleuths all fancy their chances, but you have to rely on a professional. And Miss Scarlett, when I was waiting to question you, I found something that indicated your guilt. And that thing is this. You nearly had me fooled, Mrs. White. Miss Scarlett, in the library, with a dagger.
Very close, Inspector. But actually, it was Miss Scarlett in the lounge with a water pistol.
Oh. Miss Scarlett.